हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय न्यू कोड रिस्पॉन्सिव वेबसाइट विद बूटस्ट्रैप 3 ट्यूटोरियल सीरीज वीडियो। फ्रेंड्स, इन दिस ट्यूटोरियल वी विल लर्न हाउ टू क्रिएट अ रिस्पॉन्सिव वेबसाइट विद बूटस्ट्रैप 3। एंड इन दिस ट्यूटोरियल फर्स्ट आई विल इंट्रोड्यूस यू विद द वेबसाइट एंड देन आई विल बी शोइंग यू हाउ टू सेटअप द प्रोजेक्ट फॉर विद बूटस्ट्रैप 3। सो फ्रेंड्स, इन दिस ट्यूटोरियल सीरीज आई विल बी बेसिकली क्रिएटिंग अ बिजनेस वेबसाइट। सो लेट्स हैव अ लुक एट द वेबसाइट। So if I open my browser and there is a site startbootstrap.com. So if you go to this site, so this site has free Bootstrap themes and templates. So from those free Bootstrap themes and templates, I will be picking up one business website and I will be coding in this tutorial series. So if I browse to themes and templates, so here you will see that there are many templates available. So just below you can see there is a business casual template. So this is a fully developed business website. So let's have a preview to it. So in this website you will see what were the features are available, and if I show you the live preview of it, then this is the website by the name business casual. So here you see that it's a fully responsive website. So if I say decrease the width of the browser, then you see that the images are responsive. So this website is completely created with Bootstrap 3, and in this website we will be looking into how to create this header, background, the navigational bar here, the image slider which is a carousel. We will be looking into the images, and you will see that this images which are there is provided by this Dead to the Stock photo website. So you can browse through this website and have your own images. We will also create the footer. So if I show you, there are four pages. So in the about section you will see that we will be creating this about box which describes about the website, and below you will see images available for the say members of the website. And then we will see about a blog. So this blog is the company's blog, so we will create the similar structure. And last, there is a contact page. So here we will be placing a Google map and the information about the company. And finally, at the last, we will be creating a contact form. So these are the stuffs which we will be creating in this tutorial series. So friends, you can visit this site and download the source code. So I will be downloading it first. So in this tutorial series, we will be coding the business casual website. So this, we will create the website as it is presented here. And in order to create this website, we'll need a text editor. So I will be using Sublime Text Editor. So if you go to Sublime Text website, you can download your own version from here. So currently I have downloaded my own version. So this is how Sublime Text Editor looks. And so now we'll be moving ahead with the project setup. So first we will need the Bootstrap 3. So I will be going to the website getbootstrap.com. So in this website, so here you can see a download Bootstrap. So I will click it, and among the three options I will choose the first option. So it will download the Bootstrap 3.3.6 version. So let's go to our download folder. So here you see the both zip files are downloaded. So first I will be extracting it. So if I open the website folder, so you can see that it has CSS, fonts, images and JavaScript files folder and all the four pages. So this CSS is for the Bootstrap thing, fonts is from the Bootstrap, and it has the image. So these are the images which are used in the website, and So if I open the Bootstrap folder, so here you will see the CSS font and JavaScript files for the Bootstrap 3. So first I will be going to my G Drive. So here I will create folder. Let's say I give the name as business casual. And so the first thing I will be doing is from the Bootstrap, I will just copy the CSS fonts and JS folder to the root of my business casual website folder. And also I will be using the images which have been provided by the website. So I will be just copying this image folder and I will be pasting into the business casual folder. So my business casual folder has now four folders: CSS, fonts, image, and JS. So if I go to my Sublime Text Editor, here I will open a folder and I will go to G and I will select business casual and I will open So you see that in our business casual folder there is a CSS, font, image, and JS folders. So here if I open the website on the browser, so this is the preview of website which I have downloaded. It contains the four pages, this home, about, blog, and contact. So first I will be creating home page. So into my Sublime Text Editor, create a new file and give it a name as home.html. So Bootstrap also provides a starter template to us, which contains all the things which are required to kickstart a Bootstrap 3 project. So if you go to the Bootstrap site, and so under the Getting Started menu, if you browse down, so you see there is a small HTML starter template provided. So in order to start a Bootstrap 3 project, we need to provide this meta information. So I will just copy this and to my Sublime Text Editor, I will just paste it here. So here I will just remove this title and I give the title as business casual. And as you can see, it has imported this Bootstrap min CSS, which is under the CSS folder. So if I show you, then it's already there. So we don't have to write this again. If I move down, then you can see it has included this Bootstrap JavaScript, so which is under the JS folder. So in this tutorial series, we will be also requiring our own CSS, customized CSS. So for that, under the CSS folder, I will just create a new file and give it a name as business-casual.css. So this is our file, and so this CSS file I need to import it in my head section. So I will just copy this and paste it below, and I will change the name of this CSS file as business-casual.css. So if I save it and if I run it on the browser, so you can see that our Bootstrap 3 project has been successfully configured, and now we can create our business casual website here. So friend, this was all about the introduction and project setup. So in my next tutorial, we will be seeing how to create a background and a header section of the website. Hope you like this video. Please like, comment, share, and subscribe my YouTube channel. You can also visit my blog. The link is provided in the description. Thanks, have a nice day.